impermeable protection for bodies, they still serve as a barrier between a body and the elements. Dylan Roof, after being apprehended following the murder of 9 African Americans in a church shooting in South Carolina, was outfitted with a bulletproof vest. It was meant to protect him from any vengeful elements that might want to see the murderer dead. Roof had planned on committing suicide after the shooting. His dreams of the day had ended with his own body in a coffin, protecting him from the outrage he was sure would follow. A coward's ending. But now, his remaining days will hopefully be spent in a jail where he will wither away, nothing but a failed ghost.
That's my shit.
Ethel Lance, one of Roof's victims, was last seen by her family and friends in a coffin that could not keep their love out. But their conviction, their caring grace, could not protect her from a hate crime's bullet. Black bodies remain vulnerable to rampant hate. Steel is the most common building material used to make American coffins. The most common gun used by police to put people of color into coffins is the Glock. The Glock is a series of lock-breech semi-automatic firearms used by 65% of the U.S. police force. When the first Glock was being engineered in the 1980s, the company's founder, Gaston Glock, had no experience with designing firearms. Workers inspect coffins for defects at several points during the manufacturing process. Walking down the street, a Latino man is stopped and frisked. There is a defect in the color of his skin, a dark kiss from the sun, a smear of dirt on his cheek after a long day's work. He is always being inspected, always found faulty. Black customers at the store I work at are always prepared to leave their bags up front when they go shopping, keenly aware of the way eyes follow them down the aisles. Meanwhile, white people experience the worst inconvenience of their entire day when they are asked to do the same. White people don't have to be prepared to die every time they step outside their homes. In the United States, the demand for coffins is not growing as cremation becomes more and more popular. The earth is swollen with bodies of wrongful victims. Is this our answer to violence against black and brown bodies? Do we merely turn the evidence to ashes and sweep it under the rug?